What is up, all of you amazing Frost Efficient fans out there? Welcome back to Frosty's Bar Tales. Now, I will admit, today's not Friday. It's not Frosty Friday. I didn't have a bar store yesterday. Now, I wonder why. Because Bobby Butters was supposed to send me an email telling me of a bar store he had from way overseas in Italy, but he has yet to do that. So that's the reason there wasn't a bar store yesterday. Thanks, Bobby Butters. So I decided, what the hell? Some shit happened last night, three things in particular. So I'm going to share what those were. One was confusing, and I hope to God I was just being screwed with. One was just ass backwards and made no sense. And the third was absolute bullshit, something I didn't tolerate, because no. But before I get to those, I have a very special shout out that I have to give, because I didn't forget, like someone seems to have joked that I would do. But I did not, because... So, to my friend Blaze out there, hello. Now we've gotten that out of the way. Story time! So here we go. Story number one. I'm doing IDs. I'm checking IDs on this particular evening. And this guy, I hope to God this was a couple. I do. I hope so. I'm begging. Or at least like a legit couple that's not breaking taboo in any way, if you'll get what I mean. So, the girl asks me. Girl's like yay tall. Guy's like yay tall. So, the girl asks me, don't we look like twins? So I just... Yeah. They kind of did. So I'm like, yeah, you guys kind of do look like twins. I can see the resemblance. And she goes, like, we're related, right? And I'm like, yeah, that's usually what that means. But so yeah, I see it. And the guy goes, good, because it's my sister. And then slaps her right on the ass really, really hard. I'm like, that happened. I hope they were just screwing with me. I hope that they're not actually brother and sister. I don't judge if they are, to each their own. I'm just saying, wow. Wow. Like, even as a joke, that's fucked up. But that's just my opinion. So, now onward towards, the one that made no sense. The one that was ass backwards. So, obviously, we have an owner, right? And obviously, I'm not using his name. And I'm not even going to give him a generic nickname in the off chance somebody's going to go, I bet that's his name! So, I'm not going to do that. No. Instead, I'm going to give him my name. Just to prove that I'm not using his name. So let's just say the owner of the company I work for is John Wilson, so, which it's not. And let's say that John Wilson has a son named Steve Wilson, which he doesn't. So, again, I'm doing IDs. This guy walks up to me, and he wants to go outside the front of the building, go have a cigarette, and he wants to take his drink outside with him. Against the rules. That is what we have a deck in the back for. You can take a drink out there, you just can't take it out front. So, he goes, well, I'm gonna go outside to have a cigarette, okay, boss? I'm like, no, you're not. Because you can't have a drink outside the front of the establishment. It's against the law. So, no, can't do it. Leave it inside on the windowsill, have your cigarette, come back, enjoy yourself. And he goes, what's it gonna take for me to get this drink outside with me while I have my cigarette? I said, absolutely nothing. Especially not since I'm at the front door. Not happening. And this is where it gets a little strange. His method is just mind-blowingly stupid. He looks at me and goes, well, what if I were to offer you a blowjob right now? I said, tempting, but no. So, he then looks at me, and he delivers what he should have delivered first. Why he didn't, I don't know. He goes, well, what if I told you that I own the place? I said, that's funny, because I know the guy that owns the place, and you're not him. And he goes, yeah, Wilson. I'm like, yeah, I know that. But the owner is John Wilson, not you. And he goes, yeah, but I'm his son, Steve Wilson. I'm like, let's examine this, shall we? Here's how I know you're bullshitting. Because if you were the son of the owner and you wanted to get away with something you're not supposed to be doing, you would have dropped first out of your mouth, don't you know who my dad is? Because it happens. It happens. It happens. So that's all I'm going to say regarding that. It happens. So the simple fact that he didn't drop, do you know who my dad is? The simple fact that he started with, what if I gave you a blowjob instead of my dad owns the place? Do you see where you went wrong? So, stupid, just, man, I always like screwing with you guys. Thought I was going to get you. Try your approach differently. So, now for the thing that was absolute bullshit that I did not tolerate. Now, there was a guy that was abnormally drunk. And I mean abnormally drunk. He was wasted. He was beyond white girl wasted. He was trashed. He was in a zone of drunk I have not seen in a long, long time. It was bad. So, he's with this girl. And, like, they're leaving. It's the end of the night. They're leaving. We have a revolving door. Dumbest thing ever, but I don't make decisions. So, like, she's trying to walk him to the door. Keyword trying here. And, like, he's bumping into mirrors. He's bumping into doors. He's bumping into people. Like, he's a human pinball machine. And it's like, good Lord, go outside. So, like, we have a big Jameson mirror on our wall. Like, maybe a little bit bigger than my Fight Club poster. Badass stuff. So, I mean, it's big. It's massive. And he's bumping into it and shaking the shit out of it. So it's like, dude, you're gonna break that. And if that happens, you're gonna be in some shit. So you might as well just skedaddle your drunk ass on out of here. So, what happens? She's pulling him towards the door. And I guess in a playful banter type of manner, he just shoves her into the door. Into the revolving door. And I don't just mean like a, oh, you stop. Not that. No, he like, boom. Like hard enough for her to dented my fridge. Man, my rings could really hurt somebody if I punch somebody with them. Holy shit. Anyway, so what did I do? Me not being willing to tolerate violence against women. One, me not willing to tolerate violence in front of me. Two, and me not willing to tolerate bullshit at the end of the night when I want to go home. Three, so what did I do? Especially number one. Since he was already halfway through the revolving door, I, with my left hand, shoved him as hard as I could, and he went almost through the door, because one of the doors collapsed, and we fixed it. So one of the doors collapsed, and he goes through it. And two people came up to me, and they're like, wow, you shoved that guy really hard. Like, what is your problem? Like, did you see what he did before I did that? They're like, no, then shut up. Because he pushed a woman, shoved her into the door, and she went thud. And as soon as I said that, that's when they're like, oh. Oh, well, then thank you for what you did. Thank you so much. Like, that guy's a dick. Fuck him. And then one little man walked up to me. He goes, dude, you're my hero. What is your name? And I'm like, it's John, but everyone calls me Frosty. He goes, oh, my name is blank, but everyone calls me Cap. You're my hero. We are now friends. I love you. And gave me a hug, and it was a good time. So, I done good. I became somebody's hero last night. And that should never happen, because I am not a heroic person at all. And I am no role model by any means of the imagination. So, everybody, that's going to be the story for this week. Again, I apologize for being a day late. But if you want somebody to blame, blame Bobby Butters. Because he let me down and said, somewhere between Thursday and Saturday, I will send you a message saying how I want it to be worded about his Italian fight job. Or his Italian fight story. And he didn't do that. He failed. He failed to do that, Bobby Butters. So, hopefully we will have his riveting story next week. Leave a comment down below. Let Bobby Butters know your frustrations. So, everybody, that is that. Thank you so much for joining me this week. Don't forget to join the Bomb Squad. Like, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to leave me a comment below. Let me know how I'm doing. Let me know, did I do the right thing by shoving that guy through the door? Did you guys really think they're a couple? Or do you think they're brother and sister, which is strange? You know, if you guys have an opinion or something like that, I'm leaving it there. Go ahead, leave me a comment, anything like that, so we can have a discussion based on this. So, again, hi Blaze, I didn't forget, and that is that. So everybody, I already said that. Ow. So, always remember, be safe, drink responsibly, and have fun. And don't be violent towards women. Knock that shit off. So, there's no excuse for it. Don't fucking do it. So, until next time, everybody, this is your man Frosty, your host with the most, signing off, saying, until next time, take care now, bye-bye then, stay classy.